Now, after calculating unknown forces PWR and selecting the maximum force, we have to move to the step number 2, that is design of pin. Now, the pin is designed on the basis of 3 criteria. First, based on permissible crushing stress. Second, based on permissible bearing pressure. And third, based on permissible shear stress. Now, let us design the pin by using this each criteria. So, first criteria is design of pin based on crushing stress. Now, this is the formula to find out diameter of pin based on crushing stress. The value of crushing stress sigma c is 60. The value of maximum of P, W or R is 5772.6 upon L into D. Now, here we have to determine D, but L is also unknown. Okay. So, but if you look at the problem statement here, in the problem statement, we have been given one assumption that length of pin is equal to 1.5 times of diameter of pin. Okay. So here we can write length of pin as L is equal to 1.5 times of diameter of pin, which is denoted by D. So we have been given this relation L is equal to 1.5 D. So we can put here L is equal to 1.5 D. So 1.5 D into D. So if you simplify this, you can get the value of D, that is diameter of pin based on crushing stress. So after calculation, you will get the answer of D as 8.008 mm. Okay, so this answer is 8.008 mm. So this is the diameter of pin based on crushing stress. Now let us find out the diameter of pin based on permissible bearing pressure. So this is the second criteria to find out the diameter of pin based on permissible bearing pressure, that is PB. Now here, this is the formula to find out D based on permissible bearing pressure. PB is equal to maximum of PW or R upon L into D. Value of PB is given in the numerical statement. It is 12 MPa. The maximum of PWR determined from the step number 1. It is 5772.6. In the denominator, there are two unknowns. So let us put the value of L as 1.5D. This relation is given in the numerical statement. D as it is. If you simplify this and if you solve this, you will get the answer of D. So after solving this, you will get the answer of small d as 17.90 mm. Okay, so let us write this answer. So D is equal to 17.90 mm. So this is the answer of diameter of pin based on permissible bearing pressure PB. Remember that this permissible bearing pressure value PB, you don't have to calculate it. All in every problem, this value of PB will be given. Okay. So if in some problem this value of PB is not given, you don't calculate the diameter of pin based on permissible bearing pressure, because there is no such equation is given to find out this PB, that is permissible bearing pressure. Okay. So that means if the value of PB, that is permissible bearing pressure PB, is given, use this in this equation and calculate D. But if the value of permissible bearing pressure PB is not given, you don't use this step number B to find out D. Now the last criteria to find out the diameter of pin is based on permissible shear stress. So permissible shear stress. Okay, so to find out the diameter of pin based on permissible shear stress, we have to use this equation. Tau is equal to maximum of P, W or R upon twice into pi by 4 D square. So we know that the value of permissible shear stress, it is given in the problem statement, it is 50 MPa. Maximum of PWR already we have determined from the step number 1, and D we have to determine from the denominator. Okay, so if you simplify this equation, you will get the answer of D. So if you calculate, you will get the answer of D as 8.57 mm. Okay, so we have got the three values of diameter of pin. First, based on crushing stress, it is 80.008 mm. Second, based on permissible bearing pressure, it is 17.90 mm. And third, based on permissible shear stress, it is 8.57 mm. So out of these three values, we have to select the maximum value. So therefore, let's write the statement. So therefore, you have to write this statement selecting the maximum value of D, that is diameter of pin, from above three values. So diameter of pin small d is equal to maximum value is 17.90 mm. So let us round up this value to 20 mm. Okay. So now After selecting the maximum value of diameter of pin, let us calculate the length of pin. So length of pin L is equal to 1.5D. So this relation L is equal to 1.5D is given in the numerical statement. So let us put the value of D here. It is 20. And let us find out this value. So this answer will be 30 mm. So length of pin is 30 mm. So in this step number 2, we have calculated the diameter of pin, that is 20 mm, and the length of pin is 30 mm. Now the last point that we have to determine is the size of a rectangular cross section, that is width B and thickness T of the cross section. So let us consider this rectangular cross section of this lever arm, having this is a neutral axis, this is a width B, and this is a thickness T. Okay. So remember that the lever arm is designed in two stages. First, without considering the hole for pin, and second, by considering the hole for pin. But here, as more particularly the cross section dimensions are asked in the numerical, that is B and T, so we don't have to go for second substep. So we will use only first substep, that is design of lever arm without considering hole for pin. Without considering hole for pin, okay, and we know that this dimensions B and T can be determined on the basis of bending stress by using the permissible bending stress value and equation of bending stress. So let us use this equation of bending stress. So bending stress equation for this lever arm cross section without considering hole for pin is given as MB upon I into Y. Okay, equation number 1. So here the value of permissible bending stress, we have assumed it as a 60 MPa. Now let us determine the MB, that is maximum bending moment. Okay, so if you look at this diagram, the bending moment we have to find out at point A, point B and point C, and we have to select the maximum bending moment out of these three. Okay, so let us find out the bending moment at point A. Okay, so by considering the forces on the left side of each point, that is when we calculate the bending moment at point A, we will consider the forces on the left side only. When we calculate the bending moment at point B, we will consider the forces on left side only. And when we will calculate the bending moment at point C, again we will consider the forces on left side of point C only. Okay, so now by considering, you can write here, by considering only left side forces, okay, by considering only left side forces, bending moment at point A is 0 because there is no any force on left side of point A. Okay, now say similarly at point B. Now at point B, to find out the bending moment at point B, consider the forces on the left side of point B. Okay, so force on left side of B is R, and it is vertical downward. Initially it was vertical upward, but as the answer of R was negative, we changed its direction from vertical upward to vertical downward. So R into this L2, that is 100. This bending moment is anticlockwise, so we will consider it as a positive. So R into 100, and the answer of R is, so value of R is 5195.34 into this distance AB is 100. So the value of bending moment at point B will be 51953.4 Newton mm. Okay, now let us find out the bending moment at point C. Now by considering the forces on the left side, so there are two forces. First is the force R, vertical downward, and force W, vertical upward. Now let us take the bending moment at point C. So this anticlockwise bending moment, let us take positive. So R into this distance AC is 1000, and this bending moment due to force W, it is clockwise, so let us take it as a negative. So minus W into this distance BC is 1000 minus 100. Okay, so this distance BC is 1000 minus 100 because total distance is 1000 and this distance AB is 100. So this distance BC will be 1000 minus 100. Okay, so let us put the value of R and W and let us calculate bending moment at point C. So if you put the value of R, it is 51953.4 into 1000, value of W as 577.2.6 newton into 1000 minus 100, 900. If you calculate this, you will get the answer as 0. That is, the bending moment at point C is 0. Okay. And we have to put here maximum bending moment. So maximum bending moment out of this 3 is this one. Okay. So this is the maximum bending moment. Therefore, maximum bending moment MB is equal to 519534 newton mm. Therefore, maximum bending moment out of these three is 519534 newton mm. So let us write down the moment of inertia I for this rectangular cross section. So the edge which is parallel to neutral axis is T, that we have to write as it is. The edge which is perpendicular to neutral axis is B, its cube upon 12, and y is half of this width B, that is B upon 2. So let us put the value of I, y and this maximum bending moment in this equation number 1 along with the value of permissible bending stress. So permissible bending stress is 60, value of maximum bending moment is 519534 upon I is TB cube upon 12 into y is B upon 2. Let us cancel 1B. Let us divide this 12 by 2, so it is 6. And if you simplify this, you will get 519534 upon TB square upon 6. So here two unknowns are there, T and B. If you look at the statement, problem statement, we have been given one assumption, that is B is equal to thrice T. So put in above equation, B is equal to thrice T, and let us simplify this and let us calculate the first T and then B. So here I have replaced the value of B as a thrice T, so thrice T square into T as it is. Okay. So if you calculate this, you will get the answer of T as 17.93 mm. So let us round off this value to 20 mm. And let us calculate B. So B is equal to thrice T. So therefore, thrice 3 into 20, it is 60 mm. Okay. So this is the final answer for this problem. B is the width of this rectangular cross section of lever and T is the thickness of this rectangular cross section of a lever. So with this answer, we have completed this solution of this problem.